Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Sandown Park here on Saturday. It is April the 29th, 2017. Going to look at the stakes races on today's program from Sandown. It's the final really big flat fixture until the fall. And, you know, it's a great card, the Celebration Chase. It's a great race. You have the return of Altour. And, you know, I'm going to look at races 2, 3, 4, and 5. But before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. So let's get on to it. I'm going to look at four races, races 2, 3, 4, and 5. So the 2:25, the 3 o'clock, the 3:35, and the 4:10. So let's get on to it. To the 2:25. Goes off at 9:25 in the morning here in New York City in Manhattan. So I might have to wake up early for that. The second race, the 2:25, is the Grade 2 Bet365 Oaksy Chase. It's a class one race here, going for a purse of $61,000. It's for 5-year-olds and upwards. Field of 6 horses going the distance of ground of 2 miles and 7 furlongs, or 2 miles and 7/8 over the chase course. My top pick in this one, I like the 6-horse Traffic, and pardon me if I mispronounce a horse's name. Traffic Flu-Eyed. Pardon me, like I said, the English language is not my strong point. Any language is not my strong point, but, you know, I like the 6 horses top selection. I'm going to go 6-2-4 in the tri-cast or the trifecta, 6-2-4. But number 6, Joshua Moore is on this Gary Moore trained 7-year-old gelding out of Astrabad, United States, bred horse. Most recently on the 7th of April, entry, 2.5 miles in the JLT Melling Chase, Grade 1 chase that day. His horse finished 3rd by 17 lengths behind Fox Norton. You know, really weakened out of it, a few from home. It just wasn't his day to win. Maybe he didn't like a piece of the ground. I'm not sure. Start 4th Shelton Festival on March 15th. 2 miles in the Betway, in the Grade 1 Betway Queen Mother Champion Chase. Against a little bit tougher, he did finish 6 by 7.5 lengths that day. And really couldn't have the best of closing kicks. It just wasn't his day to win. And then the Ascot Chase at Ascot, February the 18th, 2 miles 5. This horse finished 6 by 48 lengths behind Q Card. Just really was far back out of it. If you look at the last time, all the weights this horse was carrying his last few times, you know, last time out, 161 pounds, 164 at Shelton, 161 at Ascot, and start before at Newbury, he was carrying 154. He's carrying only 154 again today. I think with the less weight, you know, he should have a very good run upset here in this one. So to recap my bets for the second from Sandown, the 225, it's the Bet365 Oaksy Chase. Gonna go with the 6-horse, I'm going to go 6-2-4 in the tri-cast of the trifecta. To race number 3 now from Sandown, the 3 o'clock post time, it's the Bet365 Celebration Chase. It's Grade 1 race here for Class 1 horses, going for a purse of $154,000. It's for 5-year-olds and upwards. Field of only 4 horses going the distance of ground of 1 mile and 15/16. So that's 1 mile and 7.5 furlongs on the chase course. And, out of all the fixtures in the UK, Sandown has to be one of my favorites. You know, I like their flat course, and I really like their jumps course also. It's just a great, jumps course, I think. And there's a horse I really like in this one, and that's the 1-horse, Altour, and he'll be my top pick. I'll go 1-3 in the forecast, but this is not a race I would bet. I would just watch it for the fun of it. But number 1, Altour. Nico de Bonneville is on the Snicky Henderson trained 7-year-old gelding out of High Chaparral, very nice turf horse. But most recent at the Shelton Festival, March 14th, 2 miles in the Racing Post Arkle Challenge Trophy Novice Chase. This horse at 25 cents dollar, heavy favorite, won by 6 lengths that day. An easy victory at 2-5. It was just a great run. Start for 2 miles at Newbury. And the Betfair Exchange Chase, horse won by 13 lengths, was an even heavier favorite that day. This horse destroyed the field. And then December 27th at Kempton, 2 miles in the Wayward Lad Novice Chase, horse won by 18 lengths, 11 cents a dollar, destroyed the field. Already this season has had a victory over this course. That came in the Racing Post Henry Novice Chase, horse won by 6 lengths back in December. Same, course and distance winner, 29 cents a dollar, impressive victory. I think here again, this horse has had a very good season, has only lost, twice. I think here this horse should have a very good run. So to recap my bets for the third from Sandown, it's the 3 o'clock, goes off 10 a.m. here in America. It's the Grade 1 Celebration Chase. Going to go with the 1-horse, Altour. I'm going to go 1-3 in the forecast, but truthfully, this is a race. There's no value in it, so I would just watch it as a fan of the race. So now let's get on to race number 4. The fourth race, the 335 from Sandown, it's the Bet365 Gold Cup Handicap Chase. It's a grade 3 race here for Class 1 horses, going for a purse of $184,500. It's for 5-year-olds and upwards, field of 13 horses going the distance of ground of 3 miles and 5/8 over the chase course. My top pick in this one, I like the 12 horse, number 12, Doing Fine. I'm going to go 12-5-7 in the TriCast or the Trifecta, 12-5-7, but my top pick, number 12, Doing Fine, 9-2. Tom Scudamore is on this Neil Mulholland trained 9-year-old gelding out of Presenting. Most recently on the 19th of April at Shelton, 3 miles and a half in a handicap chase for class 3 horses. His horse won by 6 lengths that day. Was 3-1, you know, was the favorite, but ran incredibly well. A great win at Shelton a few weeks ago. You know, start for it when Canton, March 26th, 3 miles and 8th, and handicap chase class 3 horses. You know, first start since December 3rd locally at Sandown. This horse finished second by 2¾ lengths. You know, he just needed that race. Like I said, it was his first start off the layoff, and he just needed it. Then December 3rd at Sandown, 3 miles 5/8 in handicap chase class 2 horses. Horse finished second by a neck at 7-2 as the favorite, and just missed. A disappointing beat, but I think he's on the a very good run today, and I think he could win this one, and plus he has a great weight of only 143 pounds, so hopefully this one will get the job done today. So to recap my bets for the fourth, the 335 from Sandown, it's the Bet365 Gold Cup Handicap Chase. I'm going to go with the 12 horse, Doing Fine. I'm going to go 12-5-7 in the TriCast or the Trifecta. So now let's get on to race number 5, the fifth race, the 410 from Sandown. It is the Bet365 Select Hurdle. It's a grade 2 race here, going for class 1 horses, going for a purse $61,500. It's for 4-year-olds and upwards, field of 8 horses going the distance of ground of 2 miles and 11/16 over the hurdle course. My top pick in this one, I like the 3 horse, number 3, the new one. I'm going to go 3-4-7 in the TriCast or the Trifecta, 3-4-7, but my top pick, number 3, the new one, Sam Twiston Davies, is on this Nigel Twiston Davies trade, 9-year-old gelding out of King's Theatre. Most recently, on the 6th of April, the entry, 2 miles and a half in the grade 1 betway entry hurdle. Horse finished third by 6½ lengths behind Pavardier, who just ran incredibly well. You know, it wasn't catching that very tough horse. Stepping actually down in class from his last few starts, I think here this horse should have a very good run. Start before at Shelton, 14th of March, 2 miles in the grade 1 Stan James champion hurdle. This horse finished 5th by 11 lengths behind Bavardier again. You know, again, it's an incredible horse, couldn't catch him. And then start for the Stan James champion hurdle chase at Haddock, January 21st, 2 miles. Horse won by length, you know, great victory. First starts in a while, not facing a very tough horse. You know, start before this horse lost to Yanworth, then won the international hurdle at Shelton back in December, and then ran in the Dunbar Aintree hurdle last year, and didn't finish at all. You know, he fell, and Power just ran a little bit better, but he was facing so much tougher horses. I think here, stepping down in class, this horse should run a big one. So to recap my bets for the fifth, the 410 from Sandown, it's the Bet365 Select Hurdle. Gonna go with the 3 horse, the new one. I'm gonna go 3-4-7 in the TriCast or the Trifecta. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at Horse Racing Get 5. Good luck, everybody.